that's restart time, so the project is going to be started.
Y'all are aware that there's been legislation discussed and introduced by House Bill 170. This is a transportation bill that has been introduced coming out of the House Transportation Committee with the endorsement of the Speaker of the House. Chairman of that committee is Jay Roberts from Priscilla. We have been in touch with ACCG. Eric has been doing a good bit of research on the numbers as to the potential impact based on what we understand the bill to entail at this point. Keep in mind, of course, as with all legislation, that is subject to be changed and tweaked throughout the legislative process. But what we wanted to do for you is to give you some analysis of that impact as we see it at this point.
Some folks in the state have already taken a position on House Bill 170. From Lowndes County standpoint, we're still just where we're at with evaluating the bill, looking at that bill and staying very, very close on it as it moves through committee to see actually what the final bill is actually going to look like. When you've got the final bill in front of it, then you can take a position at that point of where we need to be. So there'll be further discussion as it develops, but there's a good bit of information here where we're at now.
Is everybody familiar with the bill that y'all?
Yes.
Actually, I was with some folks yesterday and got some more feedback directly from some of the legislative people directly and got some confirmation of significant changes being made to the bill. Because I aren't prepared for this, I'm speaking to the bill as it exists. It's going to be modified a great deal as it comes out of one committee. I guess it goes from a subcommittee to a larger committee, and that's what ACCG is saying. Hold off, because you don't want to be commenting on a bill that's going to look nothing like what it does now. But I'm only saying that so you know, when I saw this and prepared this, I was ready to email every legislature up there and say, well, what are you going to do? What's the government going to do? There are some indications, I won't get into specifics because it may not happen, that they may work something out that actually at least leaves you in a comfortable position. So we'll see how it goes. What I did, the ACCG had put out a bullet points on the bill that I basically just taken the bullet points and expanded on to make sure you understood all the details of it. The first one was that loss, host, loss, lease loss collected, currently being collected as sales tax on motor fuel, terminate once that tax expires. The lease loss settlement would go away and stop collecting on it. I then wanted to go through the various taxes because you may be aware that the public is constantly mixing this alphabet soup of taxes up. They don't understand what they're for. I shouldn't regret that either, because they always get it wrong. They talk about loss taxes and things.
Joe, you get it right. You get it right.
The straight rate is profitable. just a reminder, the local option sales tax was designed to be a rollback tax. There are a number of counties like Gwinnett, I know of, that do not have loss because you had to put forth the vote when that was created. So this was back in the 60s, early 70s, late. Well, they never did it for whatever reason. But if they did, they wouldn't be taxing fuel by this bill because it would be a good tax. The other problem, normally we would say the loss is not going to be in the budget, but that's the way it is right now. current authorization. Well, I've been around lawyers and legal terminology enough to know that that's a great term there. And here's one of the problems you run into in laws. After every census is done, and next will be in 2020, within 2 years after that census, you have to negotiate with the cities over how much loss is given to the county versus the owners. I can see a lawyer saying that's a new authorization to pass. You just have entered into an authorization to pass. Is that any words or temporary? So therefore, you're not going to be taxing. Once you send your new agreement in, that tax not going to be applied to you anymore. That's one problem. And then there are a number of other manipulations the General Assembly can call on to. Basically, they would prefer to have all these sales taxes off of you so they can then put in their new taxes. That's something they're trying to get offset. The O's, just so you know, this is really limited to two counties, Cabin and Rockdale. It's a homestead option tax just for homeowners. In researching this, I've started both researching, and there's a lot of talk about the rent of it. They don't like it. It's exclusive for homeowners. It's adding tax for no business. It's one of those things that problems the best way to have. I think it's hurting the local economy. So. They're the only thing that happens, probably not. Of course, SPLOST, you know, is by referendum. Now, based on the data that I was able to get, Lowndes County collects 20% of its sales tax from countywide SPLOST on sales tax is $4.2 million annually. That's $4.2 million annually. The county's portion, based on current distributions, is 1.7% of that. So I'm going to go through some numbers later, but that just gives you an idea of what kind of dollars we're looking at if that were to go away. And then I just know that it's important to remember that ESPLOST is an education tax force, and that's for the education system. They're being budgeted by referendum, and it would end, so they would lose we're uniquely having two school systems, and they didn't make that up somewhere. I think it's on the school population or something like that. It's what they do. So that would just be awful now. The impact of that is more generalized, and then, well, obviously it affects the school system, but it also affects, economic input into the community, because they do a lot of construction, and a lot of that construction for other people. If not the main contractor, at least the subs. So you got money that was all collected from the county. That's the thing about SPLOST, a good percentage of it is collected from outside the county. They put back in 100% into the county, and that's why I have an economic impact. Matter of fact, when the recession was going on, part of the problem was the SPLOST dollars were going down, and some of that money was going down, and wasn't being put back in the community. Contractors, I use an estimate trying to come up with how much is what they're talking about is putting back a 3 cent per gallon that you would have to adopt as an ordinance. Now that would be the county commission just taking a vote. I went back and tried to calculate that, but I later got data from LCC to get the exact number of how much that was going to be. So the total reduction in revenues, I think the number I came out of just for the county was about $335,000 in reduction. If you did the 3 cents, and apply that back against the loss. Now, that's just, you're short. I'm just going to Spots. That isn't the other 4.2 million spots. You can't do anything for education, so that's another 4.2 million. So in the local economy, we're looking at a $12.6 million loss of revenue that generally is put back into that economy. So that's not good, and all what you're getting back is $3.9 million on that. Now, here's one of the things I feel fairly confident when I'm hearing it's absolutely going away. It didn't intend to be this way. It didn't, in the bill, it doesn't say how the excise tax will be distributed in Lowndes County. When they did the excise, you could adopt an excise tax on energy for industry, replace that sales tax they have. When they did it, they said if the county adopts it, it's countywide. But then if the city adopts it, it's the rest of the area outside of that city. So it looked like that's what this money does for it, because they can't really calculate. Well, I've since heard they're not going to do that, because they suddenly realize, come back one city over here that's 3 or 6 cents less on gas prices than the rest of the area. And we're going to have all these gas prices all over the state to distribute this. So they seem to be backing away from that. And they come up with a way to distribute it based on a formula rather than. And I still, what I'm not clear on is how, I guess if you want that money by the formula, you're going to want to pass an excise tax to your city or county. So I guess that's how they figure it by doing it. You might have one small city that says, we're not here, and they got one gas station in the town. They're going to be the low price gas station, I don't think. So now, I kind of like that because it was real concerning that you're having this mishmash. Now, the 3 cents can be bought for 6 cents, but you have to have a low price printed. And I just noted in here, that's the state, the way of saying, we're going to throw candy off the Christmas parade float, and we're not going to tell people gradually they're going to run over. I mean, who in the world in these day and times is going to really put out a referendum for a 3% excise tax? That's insane. That's not going to happen. So you can't even count on that. And here's what might happen. There's been discussion about moving the 3 cents up to 6 cents and letting the public speech. That's when we start getting in the range of this might work. Unfortunately, they didn't make the schools. It does help them. See, if they can accomplish that. And all the stuff I'm talking about is anticipated that the bill as revised will be out next week. So that's another reason it does. Rush, or there's not going to be a long waiting period to see, okay, what you do to it. I'm in continuing contact with folks that are continuing contact with people in the state and getting said information constantly, and let's hope some of it comes true. The other aspect, and this will definitely help through, the new excise tax is for transportation only. So, it complicates things a little bit, especially if it were to start, you know, July 1, all these taxes would be paid. Because we already have a plan based on spots and the way things are going. But we could maneuver some things to the excise tax and meet that responsibility. The other thing that's being discussed is what do you mean by that? What is transportation? Do you mean construction of roads? What do you mean by that definition? If they decide that a road department that has to be maintained by government and to maintain the roads is part of that cost, then it would be great because we shift that road department under this excise tax into that general fund savings. So if they'll allow flexibility in that, and I don't know why they wouldn't. Squash, you know, we usually stick to capital because that's the way it's viewed. But if the broad definition is, especially important in small counties, they don't get enough sales tax now pave a, they could pave a road from 6 years of attack, so you might need to pave it, 3 miles out of the road. But if they'll do that, that could be an offset. Let's see. Oh, and then they get into the statewide significance. Now that they're taking the money, here's what they're going to do. They're going from 7.5 cents per gallon to 29.2 cents a gallon. This is for state funding. The rate on diesel goes from 7.5 cents a gallon to 33 cents. And that's going to be indexed every year. That's called the CPI. They are committed to increasing the LD. That's the current transportation program that's available. And every year they calculate how much they're going to put into the LD program statewide. There's then a formula based on your road mileage and population. And it then distributes to all of the state, every city and county. The county will be on the incorporated area of the population. Typically, under that formula, the counties get a market percent. I would think that's due to the road mileage and a combination of population count. If the LD goes up, and you do have to match 30%, then that would provide opportunity to go to 70% savings and only use 30% of your SPLOST dollars to match. So you're really gaining capital revenue by doing the likes of the Hill Department. He's already doing that. He has an LD. He's got a couple of projects going. So you're already leveraging what they're providing. Now, the only downside is they're not saying what to do with this, how much it's going to be. They're either capitalizing numbers on it or we're willing to do it up front in terms of telling you what it was. The Transportation Infrastructure Bank is basically a loan program. I'm not familiar that Lowndes has ever used this program because it would basically be debt and pay it back. There must be some counties using it somewhere, and they're offering all the money there. And then they got into the electric vehicles. They're going to come up with a registration fee because they're not buying fuel. They're going to make them pay $200 a year fee if it's personal, $300 per commercial vehicle. I'll let them argue that one. The other thing they were looking at is they want to stop the other, and I assume this is how they're going to bless them, from suspending the increases in the tax, like a CPI adjustment, just because the economy's doing something. And that has been done before. It's been put off in the second time. So that's what that's about. And then finally, there's something in there about giving preferential treatment to Tier 1 and 2, Tier 2 counties. These are basically, I don't want to call them poor, but your smallest counties, your smallest populated counties, maybe geographically, so they don't have any high income. Lowndes County is Tier 3, so this has no impact on it all. I guess there's some indication that these counties should be given some kind of treatment. I have the numbers behind there to show you the annual amount of SPLOST and then the amount based on it's really 19.94% of the amount we get. So it's right at 4.2 million collected on fuel sales. Also, I'm using the calendar numbers that included that fall, the budget from this fiscal year. So my numbers are a little bit larger than some others that have been calculated. County fuel sales tax would be 1.7 million. The gallon sold per the Department of Revenue was 128 million, so that was easy to calculate. Your result of the 3 cents a gallon would be 3.8. If you give enough 4.2 million, you get 3.1 in that under the current bill. And then you lose 4.2 on SPLOST insurance, and on top of that, school in Clemson, not a 4.2, that would go back to the college when they're in East Los Angeles. So the bill as it came out was not good. It is not good. Hopefully they'll make some changes like I've heard.
Any questions related to the bill?
Yes. I know the bill isn't complete, but I got to tell you, me and Bill was the chairman on the board, study, transportation study board. And personally, I like what the chairman had proposed. But when you look and you don't see anything that the ACCG committee worked on and did with the comprehensiveness of this bill here, it almost seemed like this was already planned. We just went through the motions to say that, hey, we have to give the counties and the city an opportunity to get some input, but this is nothing we talked about in our communities. And Bill gave some great suggestions, and we just was under a whole nother impression when you see this here. I'm just like, oof.
Well, I'm going to say that.
Yeah.
And along that line,
we'll wear that hat.
The introduction of the bill was unusual, too. You usually do not see these bills come out until they're almost to the point of going before the vote. I think they did it this way as a compliment. They wanted to see and get some reactions. And some of those reactions, if they're negative, they're using those to do the action on the vote.
I think what we've got here right now, though, is it's stay tuned, there's more to come. And I think next week early, we'll probably get.
As soon as I come out in writing, these 6 cents would really work for that.
Yeah.
I'm very not looking for you to have one of the cities. I think it would be fine.
So you don't want to come on this
week? We were assigned to the committee.
Last year.
Yeah,
through ACC.
Driving the making. We were all in discussion.
There's been discussion for a number of years about the increase in motor fuel tax from Georgia as historically had one of the oil fuel taxes and the declining allocation of funds for the state. And the fact that Georgia, our economy is heavily based on our transportation network. So this is not something new. The General Assembly has discussed it in the corners and in the hallways, but nothing has significantly been presented that would look like or sound like some type of increase. They all have, all the members of the General Assembly as well as the executive branch has all shunned away from any kind of discussion about an increase in that tax, but all have acknowledged the need for more monies. So the ACCG adopted a committee, appointed a committee that Commissioner Marshall and Chairman Slaughter were members of, but that was to make a recommendation, and I think what everybody is acknowledging is that the General Assembly perhaps had their own ideas about how this would shake out prior to the creation of the committee. Yeah, just to clear it up, what we served on basically was on the ACCG Committee on Transportation to basically come up with a position statement for the counties for ACCG. Hoping that certainly some of that would get into some sort of plan or legislation that they would want to introduce that was going to address transportation. Not much of it did. But we're still at the table through ACCG. I think ACCG has really got their arms around this. They're working extremely hard for the counties. And again, right now where we stand with it, it is a wait and see. We need to see what the actual bill that's going to go before the General Assembly, we need to see what it looks like. Then we'll take our position from there, begin to work our delegation and as many as we possibly can. If it's negative on our side, or then we'll come out with a position of support if it's going to work.
I recall from last time when the chief splash failed that Jay Rock was working on something that he wanted to introduce there, but it was too soon. It's just something that he had already.
Yeah, they all, this was all right. This was all, they had it all worked out. They went through the dog and pony shows, you might say. They did everything that they typically would do, but they already had this plan.
Yeah, and I failed to mention, just so you know, the school boards cannot vote the exercise tax. They're only allowed to assess property tax. So that's why they're 100% allocated.
They are present time.
They are present time, yeah.
How would this affect property taxes? Because the law should use the rollback property taxes, our property taxes would basically miss.
Yeah, I mean, they could. Now, what has happened in the past is laws, especially the laws went down before. There's a gross millage, then there's your loss rollback calculation in that millage. Because the law's going down with such a small effect on the millage, when you got down the millage, right? It might be 0.02 mills or something like that. The county basically absorbed it. In other words, they basically take the hit on that. The taxpayers don't understand that, and it'd be complicated to explain to them. Now that it's going up, it's giving you a little more room, but yeah, it will go down. It'll stop the trend of going up, just like these will do. It'll stop the trend of going up. Whether the county can absorb that into the net bill of trade, that's just if it's spread over time and it's small, you might be able to do that. But it may veer for the property tax increase so you can continue by doing what you're doing. So it does have an impact.
This was just an attempt to try to provide y'all with as much information as we could based on what we know at this point and the changes we all said. So we just got to